To the average eye, it looks picturesque, but power crews see it differently.
When you look out your door, you can see what we're dealing with. It was just devastation.
David Meserve, a 36-year veteran of PSNH, had already spent 6 days restoring power on the seacoast when he was sent to the western part of the state to help out.
I went up over Temple Mountain, I'll never forget it, and I look around, I go, I've never seen anything like this before, and I said, this is going to be a while. I knew right away. We were in for a solid week.
Heavy ice had snapped tree branches, power lines, and poles. The number of power outages broke records, and tempers flared as customers soon found out it wasn't just a matter of turning the lights back on.
One thing that people seem to forget is that our job is still very labor intensive. We're in a world of quick, you know, satisfaction. We still have to do everything by hand.
Working out of a 12-by-12 trailer similar to this, Meserve managed 120 bucket crews in the aftermath of that storm. The linemen worked 17-hour shifts.
In my mind, I had a deadline of December 24th to get my customers back on and get my crews home.
He met his goal, but at its peak, 322,000 of PSNH's 500,000 customers were without power.
I was just lucky I had enough wood to carry me through the 2 weeks. It was a grind, and my friend said that I started to go a little crazy about 7 days into it.
Chuck Perazic was one of those people waiting the storm out in a powerless house. As the days ticked by, he watched as neighbors' power came back on, and he still sat in the dark.
You know, they say, oh, no, there's a workout order out for you. Yeah, but we're, you know, everybody else got power except me, you know? So finally, I had a big piece of cardboard from a pizza box, and I wrote a nasty note, and I tacked it right to the telephone pole.
A sign counting the days he'd been without electricity. Soon after, the lights came back on.
I immediately went to Home Depot down here, and a lot of people were returning generators because they only use them. So I picked up a generator I said, now I'm all set for the next storm, which is a good thing I did, because very soon after that we had another power outage that lasted for a few days.
He also says in recent years dealing with PSNH has been much better.
They've corrected, I think, most of the problems, because even now when I call, you know, unless my name is on a list, you know, but I call and they get immediate service.
Obviously the industry is learning a lot about what's important during large events, and communications are as important as the pace of restoration. So
Bill Quinlan is PSNH's new president. He says one way the company has improved since 2008 is getting information out to their customers, one of the biggest complaints during the ice storm. The company also focused on preventative measures and worked to make the system more resilient and less vulnerable to severe weather.
We're being a bit more aggressive with respect to the actual tree removal and trim zone, so we give good sufficient clearance from our lines.
Quinlan wasn't in New Hampshire for the ice storm, but has 30 years experience in the region, coming from Connecticut. He also says nationally, mutual assistance has improved. It used to be handled regionally, but many resources across the country are now pooled together and allocated to where the greatest need is.
The reality is we live in New England, and always there's an opportunity that another serious storm could be just on the horizon. So right now we sort of see ourselves as gearing up for the next event, even though we don't know when that event is happening.
Alec O'Mara works for Unitil, another power company that found themselves caught in the middle of a power outage mess 5 years ago. They had 430 crews working around the clock, and approximately 37,000 customers were out. They too have made changes, including hiring a senior level emergency response director and implementing an instant command system, which helps them send information out to the public.
Everyone within the company has been trained in a second assignment, a storm assignment. Folks that work in our accounting department, they might throw on a vest and they're directing traffic out at a staging site when we see a major weather event come out.
And while nothing compares to the 2008 storm, there have been other major weather events bringing hundreds of thousands of power outages. For Chuck Perazic, he's barely noticed now that he has a generator, but says if he could, he'd do away with that and utilities altogether.
I wish we had more sunny days, and I would go to complete solar and go offline.
Heather Hamel, WMUR News 9.